Good afternoon, everybody. We're here obviously because of a tragic incident that occurred yesterday afternoon after my deputy responded to a suspicious incident. And then during that incident, after he arrived, a moron decided to steal his patrol vehicle, which ultimately ended up resulting in us chasing him. And then in a tragic accident where two individuals were killed because of that moron. Now I want to make something right off the bat abundantly clear, because here in a minute we're going to show you the video of the woman stealing the vehicle. My deputy did absolutely nothing wrong. I'm going to make that clear before you start asking me questions. In our world of today, we spend 95% of our time dealing with 5% of a community. And of that 5%, it is the one percenters, like you're about to see, that are the true problem out here. And we'll get into a little more in depth into that here in a minute. So Jonathan, you want to go ahead and turn it on. It's going, John.
It's going?
No, it's up.
It's going.
Now, for those of you that do not know, and a lot of individuals that are viewing right now, give you a little of what the call was. Suspicious incident. Basically what it was is we had someone reporting that another individual was attempting to take their car keys. It was a female reporter, reporting person, and a female individual that they were saying was trying to steal the keys. In 34 years, the one thing that I have learned, when we respond to calls, you never know what you're going to get. Because sometimes the reporting person is actually the suspect in the incident. Contrary to what people think and contrary to what television series out here show you, we're not God and we do not know what people are thinking and we do not know what we're about to get into. But this individual decided to do what she did and ended up the result of killing two innocent individuals. So I'm going to stop right there and I'm going to open it up to the questions.
So what wasn't clear from the video, because his camera, of course, went with him, and then next thing you know, she's in the car. How did she get in the car?
She went through the window of the passenger door. He had rolled down the window to talk to the person, to whom he doesn't know for sure. And that's why I told you, we never know when we respond to a scene. We don't know who the good person is, and we truly don't know who the bad person is all the time. And I just told you, we deal with 5% of our community. That's the bad people. Again, contrary to what people and some viewers out here think, we don't assume that every person out here is a bad person. In fact, it's contrary. We see the good in every person. So she went through the window. And you saw how fast that happened. I don't care. Even my 34 years of experience, that would have happened to me. I'm here to tell you. It would have happened to me.
So she, it's your belief, I mean, I know she's deceased. She can't speak for herself. It's your belief that she's also the one who called in the suspicious person in the first place. You believe
no, that's
there was
not,
only that, one person?
No, that's not what I said.
Okay. That's why I wanted to be clear.
No. I got a reporting person, and I got a suspect. What we don't know is actually when we arrive who truly is. We only have one. When somebody calls, we only have one side of the story. One. We just don't know until we start asking questions. And we're going to assume that you're good, not bad. Unless I know for a fact that I got a bolo out here for this bad person that you've seen me put out here. This is the bad person. This is what they look like. Here's their description. Here's their tattoos. And we don't always have that. To answer your question.
So the person who came up to the car, your deputy assumed that that would be the person who would have called him in the first place, and it wasn't.
I'm not going to assume what my deputy was saying, but more than likely, yes. That's the odds are yes.
Sheriff, what is the department's policy on the cars running or not running when your deputy leaves the vehicle? Because it seems like the car was running and she had access to drive away in it.
I have a feeling y'all going to push my buttons. That means shit. Okay? That doesn't play a factor in anything. This moron stole a police vehicle and killed two human beings. What my policies are, what the procedures are, mean nothing. We did nothing wrong. My deputy did nothing wrong. Listen, you did it. You've pushed me. Our society today wants to blame everything else but where the blame should be. Not a policy, not a deputy. The blame goes to this individual. You want to know why? Let me open it up to you. You want to know why we in law enforcement push so hard on our legislators? And let me make something clear. Our governor in the state of Florida, Ron DeSantis, is a great governor. Our legislators, the unsung heroes, is our legislators in the state of Florida, cut above any others in this nation. Leaders like President Pasadomo, Speaker Renner, and all the others. And it doesn't make a difference if there's an R or a D in front of their name. They are outstanding leaders in this state of ours, and they do everything to protect every citizen they can. Now, legislation can only do so much and hopes that when law enforcement does their job, that the courts does their job, prosecutors do their job. Ladies and gentlemen, this is her criminal history. This is it. Criminal history. Zach?
Each page of the arrest history?
Yes. In her life, 13 felony charges, 9 misdemeanors. Out of those, 2 convictions on misdemeanors. Now, here's what infuriates us in law enforcement. Now, Marion County, you should know by now, in Marion County, we uphold the law, we enforce the law, and we put bad guys in jail. And I'm going to give kudos to my state attorney in the 5th Judicial Circuit, Bill Glatzen, the best state attorney in this state. And the men and women, assistant state attorneys that work for him are the best, and they do their job every single day. We arrested her. All those charges are in other counties, except for one, Marion. We arrested her. We charged her. We convicted her. We, the state attorney's office, got a conviction and got 2 years sentence. 2 years. In 2022. Keep that year in mind right now. 2022. 24 months they got. Then, because she violated a probation out of Orange County, they picked it up. Violated her. Gave her 30 months concurrent to our charges. When it should have been consecutive. Not only on top of that, did she get a very, absolutely, in my opinion, nothing. Nothing. She should have received 53 months. What year did I tell you? 2022. If she would have served what we in Marion County did, and if Orange, and keep in mind, I want you to pay attention to the year, which was 2023, April, when a particular prosecutor that was there, it should have been 53 months. I know math is hard, even for me. I only got so many fingers and toes. If this person would have been in jail, I would not have two dead innocent people. Her, I don't give a crap about.
Sheriff, I know you said you can't speak for the deputy, but can you speak for the department what it was like getting the call that the car was stolen, not knowing what's going to happen next, not knowing why you were called out initially?
Panic. Panic. Because we know what's in the vehicle. There's a long rifle in there. The moment she did that, she was a threat to human life. Threat. For just merely getting in that car. I mean, think about that for a minute. What do citizens think when they see a blue lights coming down the road? They think it's a good person. Not an asshole like this. It's panic. Sheer panic. We need to stop her.
Sure.
We need to put an end to it.
Can you confirm that the person that we're speaking about right now is Caleb Boone? Kendra.
Kendra Boone, that is correct. Born in 1990.
Thank you.
Sheriff, do you think any policy would be looked at in the future?
Don't go there. No.
Okay.
I'm not. No. No. We didn't do anything wrong. What do you people not get? You want to put the blame somewhere else. The blame is on this Kendra Boone. Not a policy. Not what my deputy did. On her. You want to fix our problem in society, hold people accountable. Juveniles to 100 and some years old. It's as simple as that.
Were the innocent people here, were they local, the victims?
I don't know, and it really doesn't make a difference to me. It was a person, it was a human being in my county that I'm charged to protect, that I do every single day. And because of this one percenter, they're dead now. And I got a third one to whom I haven't even been given an update on, that I don't even know if it survived.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. You don't have any update on their condition, right? All right, thanks, Sheriff.
Any other questions?
Sheriff, just based on the fact that you said that she had a pretty lengthy rap sheet, well-known in your county, I'm just curious, did the deputy know this? I know you said that at the time you pull up, you don't know, but clearly she seems to be a familiar person to your department.
Not to me. She's only been here once. And we got her.
What was that charge in 2022?
I'm not sure if I can tell you. Am I?
Fleeing to eluding.
Fleeing and eluding. Oh, that's a shock.
What were the other counties that she was arrested in besides here in Orange?
Volusia, Orange. I can't remember. There's cities in there. There's municipalities, but I'm not for sure where those municipalities, which counties those municipalities are in. And law enforcement did their job in those. Let me make that clear. Law enforcement obviously made their charges. Law enforcement did their job. Somewhere else, there's a breakdown. And that's the problem.
Anything you'd say to the families of the two people who lost their lives, the others in the hospital?
Listen, my heart goes to them. I lost a friend first thing in the morning at 7 a.m. A good man. And then I have to deal with this moron who kills two. And to them, my heart pleads to them. My heart truly does. Now I pray and hope that they are standing before our good Lord Jesus Christ right now.
You may have missed this, but is there an identification for the two people that lost their lives yet?
Have we released that? We haven't released it. And FHP is working that portion. So most of the time we defer to them in regards to that. Okay.
Are they lead on this? So any
for the crash, to crash itself.
And as far as the deputy whose car was taken, anything going on with your deputy? Is he on leave or is he still working?
Nope. He is not. He's still working. He's probably on days off. We got days off, so.
Was he hurt at all?
No. Was not. Thank God. My deputy was fine. Because you've seen those. You've seen it where we try to stop a moron like this and end up getting drugged down a road. I'm thankful that he is not hurt. So, any other questions? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.